You can set up your very own self-hosted password manager that's both private and secure, and I'll show you how in the next few minutes, step by step, even if you never touched a server before. We'll set up an Ubuntu virtual private server on Comatera, just $4 a month or totally free if you use my $100 credit. Then we'll install and configure Docker, use Caddy for an encrypted reverse proxy with HTTPS, and install Vaultwarden, a lightweight open source password manager trusted by thousands, so you can privately manage all your passwords securely from anywhere without relying on third-party services. So let's get started. Now, like I said, I'll be using a VPS to host Vaultwarden, so my passwords are always accessible online. But if you want to self-host at home, you can still follow along with just a few tweaks. Otherwise, go ahead and grab your free $100 VPS credits and meet me over in your Comatera dashboard. What we're going to do is go to the My Cloud section and click on Create a New Server. And then for the zone, pick a location that's closest to you. This is going to be the physical data center where your VPS server exists. I'm going to pick Atlanta. And then for an image, pick Ubuntu. And we want the latest long-term support version, which is 24.04. And then for server specs, we'll pick A for the type. And basically, Vaultwarden is super lightweight. We don't need too many resources, so we'll go with the bare minimum here. One CPU core, 1 gigabyte of RAM, and 20 gigabytes of solid state drive storage, and that's just $4 a month. We'll come on down here, and we get 5 terabytes of data transfer per month for our VPS. Then go ahead and create a password for your server, and then you can give your server a name. I'll call mine PW for password Vault. All right, that looks good. So it's just $4 a month. Go ahead and click on Create Server. And when this finishes in just a minute, I'll catch back up with you. All right, our server is up and running and it has been assigned this IP address. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy that to my clipboard. Basically, if you're just playing around, you can use this technically to host your password manager. But if for a production server, I do recommend associating it with a domain name, which is what I'm gonna show you how to do next. And basically that involves wherever you bought your domain name from. I bought my domain name Lulanta from NetIM here. So go into your domain name registrar. The concepts are gonna be very similar, and find your DNS settings, or it could be called a zone file. And in order to map that IP address to the domain name, we're gonna add a new record. So click on Create a New Record. The type is going to be A, and the target will be the IP address of your VPS server, and you can host it directly on your domain name, but it could be a good idea to host it at a subdomain. So I'm gonna put mine at vault.lulanta.org. And then we'll confirm that. And then you can see down here that the record has been created and we are mapping this IP address to that domain name. It could take a few minutes, up to 24 hours, for that propagation, that association to happen. But if not, open up a terminal window if you're on Mac or Linux. And if you're on Windows, you can open up a command prompt and we're gonna log into that remote server with the SSH command. So you're gonna type SSH root at your domain name or your IP address, in my case, vault.lulanta.org, and then hit enter. And if you don't get this message about the authenticity of the host, then the DNS propagation probably hasn't happened yet, so just give it a few more minutes. And otherwise, are you sure you want to continue connecting? Type yes, hit enter. And then the password that we just created a minute ago, go ahead and type or paste that in. And there we go. We are connected to that remote server in the data center. So at this point, as is always good practice, we want to do an apt update to get the latest and greatest packages on our system. And as you can see, there are 87 packages that can be upgraded. So let's go ahead and follow that up with an apt upgrade. Hit enter. That's going to be 306 megabytes of additional disk space. Do you want to continue? You can do capital Y, hit enter. And we'll let that do its thing. Okay, that has finished. And the next thing I want to do is to, instead of using the root user, let's create a new user that we can give sudo privileges to, just so that way we don't have that security vulnerability. So in order to do that, we can do add user and then the name of the user that you want to add. I'm going to call my user Tony and then pick a password for that user and confirm it. And then you can give his name or your user's name. And then all this is kind of outdated, so you could accept the defaults. Capital Y, hit enter. Okay, so we have a new user called Tony. Let's give that user sudo privileges. And we can do that with the user mod -a capital G sudo. Tony, and hit enter. Now that user has sudo privileges for installing packages and whatnot, and we can switch over to that user with su-tony. And as you can see, we are now Tony instead of root. Next up, let's install Docker and Docker Compose because we're going to use those to configure Vaultwarden. So in order to do that, we can do this. I'll have these commands down below. We're going to curl from get.docker.com the docker.sh script. And then to execute that, we can do sudo sh and then that script, which is in our directory now. Hit enter, type in your password, and that's going to go ahead and take just a minute to run. And when that's finished, we want to add Tony, the Tony user, to the Docker group. And we can do that with something very similar to what we just did. Sudo user mod dash a capital G Docker instead of sudo, and then the name of the user, Tony. Hit enter. And in order for those changes to take effect, let's just exit out of our Tony shell session, and then we can come back in with su-tony. All right, next up, let's install Docker Compose. We can do that with sudo apt install docker-compose, and we could do the dash y so we're not prompted. Hit enter. All right, now we have Docker and Docker Compose. Let's make a directory where Vaultwarden will exist. So we can do mkdir Vaultwarden, and then let's go into that directory with cd Vaultwarden. And obviously there's nothing in here. Let's make our first file. You can use any text editor that you want. I'll use nano, and the file is going to be docker-compose.yaml. This is our Docker Compose file. Hit enter. And I'm going to paste this in here. Again, I'll have these snippets down below in the description. Basically, version of the Docker Compose file is version 3. And under the services, we're going to nest under Vaultwarden. Basically, we're pulling the latest image of Vaultwarden from the Docker servers. We're going to call it Vaultwarden, and we're going to restart it unless it's manually stopped. We're assigning it a couple, just one volume actually, our data volume. And then the thing that you're going to want to change for yourself is the domain name. So mine's going to be at vault.lulanta.org. You could do your domain or your IP address. Initially, we're going to allow signups. So that's signups allowed equals true, but we're going to come back in and change that to false a little bit later. Finally, we're mapping our ports 8080 to just 80. And if that looks good, go ahead and do Control X, capital Y, hit enter to save the file. And next up, we're going to make a Caddy file in this directory. In case you're not familiar, Caddy is a web server and it automatically provisions an SSL certificate for you, which will enable HTTPS encrypted connections. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll do the same type of thing, nano Caddy, capital Caddy file, hit enter, and then I'll paste this snippet in here. So for the first line here, vault.lulanta.org, replace that with your domain name. And then you saw we were mapping in the Docker Compose file, port 8080 to port 80. That's where this comes from, our local host, which is the host name of our local server. And we'll enable gzip compression. So Control X, capital Y, hit enter to save that. And now we need to go back into our Docker Compose file and make sure that we pull down Caddy, the Caddy application as well. So we can come down to the bottom of this under services still, and I'll paste this in here. All right, that looks good. So under the Caddy section, we're gonna pull the latest version of Caddy. We're gonna call it Caddy, same type of thing, restart it unless it's stopped. We're gonna map ports 80 to 80, 443 to 443, which if you're not familiar, those are the HTTP and HTTPS ports. And then very similar, we have some volume stuff down below where we have that Caddy file that we created. We're going to map that to the Docker container and a couple other volumes here. So if that looks good, go ahead and do Control X, capital Y, hit enter to save. Next up, let's run our Docker Compose file. So basically in that directory, you can do docker-compose up dash D, and the dash D here is daemon mode, so it'll run in the background. Go ahead and hit enter, and it's gonna pull down all those packages and configure everything as we specified. All right, now unless you get an error here, our Vaultwarden is running and our Caddy is running. So let's go ahead and minimize this. And at this point in a browser window, you can open up a new tab and go to your domain name or IP address. So I'm going to go to vault.lulanta.org, hit enter, And actually, it doesn't work. We get a 502 bad gateway error. And I'm not going to edit this out. This will help us understand the concepts of Docker and Caddy a little bit more. So let's go back into our server and basically take a look at our our Docker Compose file. So in here, we can see that we are mapping with these ports the external port to the internal port. And we have multiple ports listening on port 80 in the container. And that's okay as long as these external ports are unique. So basically, where we went wrong is, well, we could use the container name, which is acts like a host name, and we need to be listening on the internal port of 80, not 8080. So basically, in our Caddy file, instead of localhost 8080, we want that to be Vaultwarden and port 80. So we'll save that, and we can restart the Docker Compose file with docker-compose, restart Caddy, hit enter. Okay, that's done. Now let's minimize this and go back to our web browser, refresh the page, and this time we see the login page. Now, because in our Docker Compose file, we said allow signups equal true, we have this button down here that says create account. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna create an account and click on continue. And now you're gonna need to pick a master password. Now this is super important because this is the password for all your passwords. So make sure it's long, it's unique, it's random, it's all the good stuff, all the good password techniques that you've been taught over the years. So go ahead and type that in and then confirm it. And if you want to do a hint, you can do a hint. Otherwise, you can create your account. And here is the Vaultwarden dashboard. Now, before we do anything in here, unless you want to create multiple accounts, like allow multiple users to access your Vaultwarden server, it's a good security practice to disable the ability for new signups. So let's go back into our terminal window, open up our Docker Compose file, and we just want to change signups allowed to be false. And this time we'll do docker-compose down to bring the whole Docker Compose down, shut everything down, and then Docker Compose up. And actually, if we do Docker Compose up without any other arguments, it's gonna block our terminal access. So let's do Control C. And instead of that, we'll do Docker Compose up dash D for daemon so it runs in the background. And now this way, no additional signups can happen on your server. Now, because of the nature of the password manager, we want to add an additional layer of security. We can do that with a simple firewall, which we're going to be using UFW in this case, and this should already be installed. So you can do UFW, actually we're going to need to do sudo UFW allow open SSH, and this is going to allow us to log into our remote server via SSH, type our password, that rule is updated. I'm going to do that sudo UFW allow HTTP, and then we'll do the same thing for HTTPS. Finally, we'll do sudo UFW enable to enable the firewall, and it's okay. We can continue because we allowed our open SSH. It won't disrupt our connection. Y, hit enter. And now if we do a sudo UFW status verbose, we can see that our firewall rules are active and only allowing traffic on these ports. All right, at this point, let's do a quick demo of Vaultwarden. So we need a client to access this remote server. So I'm going to download a Bitwarden application on my browser here. So the connection between Bitwarden and Vaultwarden is basically Vaultwarden is an open source alternative to Bitwarden. Bitwarden has paid plans here, but we're self-hosting this, so we don't need to worry about that. And they're fully compatible. So basically, I'm running Google Chrome, like I said. Let's go ahead and download the browser extension to integrate that with our browser. We'll go ahead and add that to Chrome. And then as it says here, we can pin this to our browser. So we can click on this pin right here. And that way we can see our passwords, any page that we're on. So what we want to do, click on that, log into Bitwarden. So the same credentials that we just created on our server, we can type that in, continue. Now that master password, we want to go ahead and type or paste that in. And down here, it says we're accessing bitwarden.com. That's actually not true. We want to do a self-hosted option. And the server URL, which is going to be, as you can figure out by this point, https://vault.lulanta.org, and save that. And now we can log in with our master password. Perfect, we're logged in and it says our vault is empty. That's because we haven't added any passwords. So let's go ahead and do that next. Let's see, let's go to reddit.com and make an account with Reddit. So I will go log in and sign up. So I'll create an account here. continue. I'll paste in that verification code, click on continue, and then I'm fine with that username. And if we click here, you can see the Vaultwarden browser extension already helping us out. Instead of, you know, using those easily guessable passwords that you just memorize, we can do a randomly generated password like this one. So I'll go ahead and accept that and click on continue. And then up here you see, should Bitwarden remember this password for you? We do want to remember it. We can organize this too into folders. I won't do that. I'll just go ahead and save it. And our password has been saved. Our account is created at this point. I'm going to go ahead and skip through this stuff. We're going to go back over to our Vaultwarden dashboard right here. We'll refresh that page and log back in. We'll click on unlock. And now we can see that we have our first password in here for reddit.com. There is the email. If we click on the link here, it'll actually open up the login information, our username, our password. If we want to copy it, we can copy it or we can view it directly like that. Also over here under tools, import data, if you do have an existing password manager that you want to migrate away from, you can download that. They support multiple formats, JSON, CSV, and whatnot, and then just upload that to here so that all your passwords are in here. And again, because of the nature of the importance of passwords and security, I do also recommend coming over to settings and security and enabling a two-step authentication, either through the authenticator app or a physical hardware key. And just as important, you need to take one more step to lock down your server itself. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to set up an SSH key and disable both root and password logins, which is a critical step to protect your password vault. I get into the tutorial probably around 2 minutes and 35 seconds, so you can jump ahead and we'll get right into the hardening steps. I'll see you over there.